Vedavyas. Vedavyas was the one who put the Vedas into their current form. Gave them, they were all mixed up. So it definitely speaks of a very stellar lineage. And Vashishtha Rishi was the Kulguru of Sri Ram, the Raghuvanshis.
Yes.
And it was because of Vashishtha Rishis that many Rishis like Vishwamitra and many other got enlightened. We will, if time permits, we will move into that story, or you can always have another session. So now what kind of inferences can you draw from these people? They are very affable people. They try to bring people together. They like to work in groups. There's a loss of parent at a very early age.
Oh.
There can be a loss of parent, and you are being reared up by a stellar personality. They're very sensitive and emotional. There's somebody whom you look upon as a parent could also be taken into account there. They have a very emotional interior, and though they might portray a very tough exterior, they have a very emotional and a very soft interior in that. You could be raised by a very stellar personality. You could be influenced by a very stellar personality, mentored by a stellar personality. You are lucky and you are protected. Mitra is a person who a true friend would stand in your stead to take in the arrows, to take in the, all the spheres, every dart to protect you. So you're protected. Mitra gives a lot of protection. And, it's a traveling. Mitra is somebody, it's these people, as if you, when we do about Saraswati later on, you know that these people have a love, a divine love for other cultures. So they are, that gives them the ability to move and to interact with people of other cultures very, very easily. These people have the ability to make other people very, easy, if I can say the word.
Very comfortable.
Yes, very comfortable. So if you wouldn't be looking, but you wouldn't be seeing that, this is the first time I've met a person. You would be happy. You can be a little relaxed with that person. And since when we can also take, there's a chance of surrogacy or test tube babies for these people, surrogate mothers here, because this is also the sign, as you say, of Scorpio, hidden womb, female genitals. Not to mention that in the story you saw that they discharged their semen. Okay. So if by any chance, for those people who want to, try their luck with surrogacy or to try their luck with test tube babies, when moon is moving through the Anuradha Nakshatra, this is a good period to try.
Okay.
But it should not be in your 6, 8, 12 houses. Then I have nothing to say.
Okay.
Because then it is left to chance and destiny.
Yeah, because every nakshatra will have some pros and cons depending on the place and other transits always.
Yes. So, there. Now, when I was talking about stellar lineage, this is the chart that is very, very prominent, is of Caroline Kennedy. Caroline Kennedy is the only surviving child of John F. Kennedy and Lady Jacqueline Kennedy. Okay. Jacqueline Kennedy, though she had a brother who passed away in an airplane crash, the plane that he was driving, but she is a very strong lady. She is known to be an American author. She's an author, she's an attorney, and she's a diplomat. She's also served as a United States ambassador to Japan. And she has, and you can read this, that she served for no less than 4 years there. Now let's move on to her chart. When you see her chart, you will see that sun here is located in the Lagna along with Saturn. Okay. And it is the 10th Lord. Now I have to be very honest. I have checked this out with number of charts. When Sun, Saturn are together, aspecting each other in each other's houses, then there's a major karmic relationship with father. And there's a number of times that after the birth of the child, the father might suffer in some way or the other. And this is something that I've tested in many a charts.
Okay.
So, but that is for a different issue. Here we see that she lost her. It's also in the... So this connection definitely gives more, gets more power because it is placed in Anuradha Nakshatra. We have seen that there is a chance of losing a father figure or a father at a very, you know, early age. So she lost when she was, her father, John F. Kennedy, was assassinated when she was just 5 years of age. And she was mentored, brought up by her mother and her uncle, Bobby Kennedy, okay, till he was assassinated. And her uncle was again a very stellar figure in her life.
Okay. So do you also say that, I mean, indirectly, that these people should look to guides who are like very big personalities, then their lives can improve?
If not just I say that, they will be drawn towards such people. If they are very focused in their work, time will definitely, because this will draw them together towards zone. Because they are destined to do those things. They're destined to be those people. But you have to do something, you know. If you want a plant to grow, the first thing that you do is sow the seed.
Got it.
So the seed will only become a plant when you have done something very, you have done the first thing and you then keep watering it. Don't just think that, you know, the first day the seed is going to grow into a tall tree. It's not going to happen like that.
Overnight success
is not, it's something that doesn't stay. It's honestly speaking, I'll just take a minute off to deviate, but overnight success is something like the eclipse. If you've ever witnessed the eclipse, what happens is it's a sudden burst for 30 seconds, for 1 minute, and then everything becomes dark all over again. And then things start resuming at their normal space. So overnight success is something very much like that. Even the sun takes 4 to 6 hours to rise up to the sky.
Yes, yes.
It will eventually happen, but we need to have that patience. So let's come back to the analysis for Caroline Kennedy. What does she do? She is, as I said, a diplomat. This nakshatra, we've already discussed, Mitra provides that diplomacy. Sun is representative of father. We've seen that she's lost her father at an early age. Sun is also the representative of the government. So she has worked for the government. And in the 10th house, I mean, you know, it's the 10th lord. So it's very strong. It's a very strong lord. So it gives her the power to work for the government, with the government. And it's related with third lord. Who's the third lord? Third lord is Saturn. Third lord, Saturn sitting here, and the fourth lord, it's third lord is writing contracts, lawyers, and fourth lord is that of the masses. On whole, this is a very strong chart, as Caroline Kennedy has to, you know, her chart says. Another tenth chart that I would like. Yes?
Tenth lord in the Lagna, very strong placement.
Yes, but it was shadowed by the nakshatra. But because it was also the nakshatra lord, Saturn at times has also helped her.
Yes, and because this is in the ascendant, this becomes 10,000-20,000 times more prominent, all these traits of the nakshatras.
Yes, they fortify the nakshatras.
Yes,
they fortify the nakshatras or the chart. Or if there's a very malefic sitting there, then it will kind of bring the person down. Like no
end. And if you see, Saturn is also the dispositor of moon here, so then it becomes more prominent.
Yes, so you have the mind, you have the lagna, the body, the soul, everything working for her very, very intently and very closely.
Yes, harmony.
Harmony, synchronicity. So I'll take the case of Gordon Ramsay. Now let me You know that retrogrades, you've just introduced that, you know, on my channel I have a lot of things on retrograde. So let me introduce you a bit of retrograde here also. We have this nakshatra in particular is said to be one with has a very pleasing speech.
Okay.
Mitra, well, you don't want your friend always to be on a very sour note.
Yes.
You want a friend who is also very pleasing in his speech, who is very helpful in his speech, who is very uplifting in his speech. And Mercury, what does Mercury specify? What does it signify? It signifies speech. Okay. And here for him, Mercury is retrograde. So retrograde Mercury will definitely show a different trait. Retrograde does not mean bad. For decades it has been told that retrograde is bad. No, it is not. Let us go back to the classics and read. It has very categorically stated that even in the longevity, retrograde planets get a lot of, they get a lot of prominence. If a retrograde planet is debilitated, then it is considered to be an exalted planet.
Yes.
Depending on its positions, retrograde planets, I quote from the classics. I can give you the classics from where I'm quoting. So retrograde planets are not bad, no matter who says it. Because people believe only in classics, I can open the classics and show that they say that the retrograde planets are not bad. And retrograde planets are said to be a very strong planet when you consider your opportunities. Nothing bad. So this Gordon Ramsay says everybody knows 16 Michelin stars to his credit, a restaurateur, a very, very well-known cook, okay, from UK, moved on, mentored. He comes from a very cranky family, especially his father was a alcoholic and he had very little relations with his father, but he was mentored by well-known chefs the world over. As I said, there would be movement away from father, disassociation, loss, or something or the other, but you would always be mentored. You would always be protected, always be guided, because that is what Mitra does. So he was mentored by well-known chefs and he went on to become a class apart in his own way. In the US, when he started, he has a show by the name of The F Word.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah. And that's a cooking show. Okay. That's a cookery show. And he's said to drop. And I've seen, you will, in his shows, you will see the beeps happening more frequently than the words coming out.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But he has the heart of a gold. When he had gone to one of the prisons, and he saw a prisoner chopping. After seeing the dexterity of the prisoner, in chopping the vegetables, he offered him a job the moment he came out of the jail. He offered him a job in one of his hotels. Now, which person would go ahead and give a knife to a convict?
Yeah, yes.
So he's done that. His exterior, the Mercury speech is not up to the mark because it's a retrograde. But the nakshatra imparts its color and giving him the ability to help others and be helped in return.
Okay, so basically you are saying here that because it is retrograde, that is that nature of the nakshatra is becoming even more strong with respect to Mercury.
The nakshatra, it's going in the opposite direction at times.
Yes, okay.
It depends on a number of things. It depends which planet.
Because it is in sixth house, that also can be one flavor which is...
Yeah, so he's so much open into controversies. Sixth house is
yeah.
Also controversies.
Yes.
Is the Lagna Lord? Is the fourth lord of kitchen sitting here?
Okay.
So he is so much in always into the turbulent phase with his words and things, but his deeds are good. See, retrograde nakshatras are area we will take on later some other day, but this is something just to say that there will be a flavor which will be different And sometimes what happens is when the nakshatra also gives, has something that a retrograde planet is essentially is, then it will become more pronounced in a person's chart, depending on the nakshatra, depending on the planet. So now we move on to the symbol. What is the symbol of this nakshatra? One of the, this nakshatra has many symbols. Let's take one thing at a time. We'll take the first symbol is that of triumphant gateway, or the toran, or the bandarwar, or the archway that you see. Okay, the archway leads you to a new place. So it's all about new beginnings. Okay, it's also, you come to a place, you see there are two archways. It's also about moving to a different zone. And what happened in the olden times, you saw that when somebody came victorious, the gates of the village or the town were decorated.
Yes.
So that was a triumphing situation. So that is movement into, you know, this is one of the victories that a person faces. Okay.
Okay.
And it is also when you, this, it's a very small path. It's not a wider path. So when you're oriented, you're moving, you can see your goals. Can you see a goal? Can you see the road right down the street?
Yeah, yes.
More and more focused.
Okay.
And you're becoming more oriented towards your goals. More structurized. And there's a transformation. You're moving from one zone to another. So it's like Alice in Wonderland moving into that tunnel, coming to something very different.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this is a transformation, movement from one place to another. Again, you see that this is an initiation. This is a new movement. You come to a doorway. You know, you go to a park, and then you come across two, three archways. They say this one is leading to this place, this one is leading to this place, and this one is leading to another third place. So you take an initiative to move into one zone. So this is also a change. It is a transformation, and it is an initiation to a different process. So when a key planet is transiting for you from, say, your 10th lord is transiting in the, your 10th lord is moving through this planet, through this nakshatra in transit, then what happens? There's ample time for you to think up of new avenue, new beginning, new initiation, new transformation. You want to bring about some change in yourself, if it's about the 6th house or the 8th house, because or the 3rd house for you. Then there's a lot of psychic energies that you can use up to bring about a new change.
Okay.
Interesting. So you need not have a planet always posited there. If there is a transiting planet for you moving there, then that planet definitely owns certain houses in your charts, is placed in a certain house. With respect to that, these things can happen in your life.
And when Saturn was transiting Anuradha, then maybe so many things happened.
Yes, so they were also thinking of new things, probably.
Yes, yes.
People must have won situations in life. They might have become more focused in life, depending on which house it is, depending on which planet it is. Now you will see Jupiter moving in. You will see Jupiter also moving in. Jupiter is the 9th lord of the zodiac, the 12th lord of the zodiac. Okay, and when Jupiter is moving through this nakshatra is also, we have seen very clearly that it is also a very strongly spiritual nakshatra.
Yes.
Jupiter will be moving into this nakshatra and will also be aspecting its own house, the 12th house of meditation, the 12th house of a lot of, going to ashrams, going to pilgrimages. So for anybody, if it's for the Aries Lagna, it's the 8th house, then a person might be doing that or could be doing some research, because it's also about transformation, change, initiation. For a Cancer Lagna, it's about the fifth house. So this person could be doing something into the Mantra Shakti because Jupiter is in the fifth house and the ninth house.
Yes, yes. Then for Leo and this, it becomes much more stronger.
So you see the way even the transits are being affected by this nakshatra, and they, as a planet moves over this nakshatra, it gives its own color.
Okay.
Saturn movement will have a different color. Jupiter movement will have a different color. Venus movement will give a different color, and Mars will definitely impart a different color altogether. Okay. So we move on to, it's also letting go of the old and moving into the new phase. And there's a sense of duality because here you are to let go of the old, move into a new zone. It's a completely different area for you. And finally, protection. As I said, it is covered from all sides. So this also gives you a protected, an easy, thorough pathway. You don't see people jumping out of, the archways to kill you or something like that. No, they want more ground. So this zone is protected.
Okay.
And this is a period of transition for you. People probably, when you will see that when planets are moving into this zone, they are probably moving into a new state of being. They're probably psyching themselves to move into a new state of being.
Okay.